Hola a todos, soy Señora Neslahowski, and welcome to my lesson on noun adjective agreement. Make sure you have your Cornell notes, nombre, hora, y fecha, and fill in the tema, the theme, of noun adjective agreement. By now, we've already gone over your definite and indefinite articles, so we know how to say the boy or a boy. But what happens if we want to describe the boy? That's what we're going to do today. We're going to take the article, which is combined with the noun, remember they're like one word, and we're going to start describing them with all of our adjectives. Can we say tall, funny, short, rich, poor, anything? So we're gonna learn how to do this. Now, noun adjective agreement could be describe people, but it also can describe objects. Big house, little house, expensive car, cheap car, any type of adjective. So here we go. First and foremost, what we need to know is that the gender and number of the article, the noun, and the adjective must all match. Think about like putting together a really well put together outfit. You gotta make sure it all flows together. So here I stuck with boy and girl, so we can keep it simple. If we're using our definite articles, which means the word the, we would have el chico, la chica for the singular forms of the, masculine and feminine, or the plural forms, los chicos and las chicas. So here, these are your articles with your nouns, and they're connected. They have to match already. Now, we're going to add the sentence, or add the adjective, into the sentence. For today, I'm going to use the adjective tall, alto. Now, alto can be changed to fit with boy and girl, or boys and girls. Not only can we adapt and change the ending, that letter O can change, we also have to know where it goes. With noun adjective agreement, it is imperative that we remember noun goes first, adjective comes second. Well, why would we do that? Well, I'm going to describe the boy in Spanish. I have to match the ending to the gender. I have to know what I'm describing before I describe it. So in English, I can say the tall boy, but in Spanish, I have to say the boy tall. So if I was going to do that, I would say, el chico alto. Now here you might say, well, there's no change. That's because in the Spanish language, the default of the language is masculine singular. But I'm going to make this plural. I'm going to make it the boys, los chicos, and now I see plural with the S. I see plural with the S, so I have to take alto and also make it plural with the S. Altos. So I go from masculine singular, masculine singular, masculine singular. Masculine plural, masculine plural. This side is all masculine plural. This is all masculine singular. So what about for la chica? I have la chica, the girl. Now, I don't want to use an O because the O is going to tell me it's going to be masculine. I'm going to stick with the A's. So I'm going to say la chica alta. Here, I'm going to say the girls, las chicas altas. So, I now have feminine, singular, feminine, singular. The A's across, they all match. And then I have the plural. Plural feminine, plural feminine, plural feminine. So if you see an adjective in your book, you'll see an O/A because you can change this to O, os, a, and as, and it all fits together. So by doing this, we say el chico alto, we translate it the tall boy, but because these last few letters have to adapt and change to match the noun, we have to put the noun first. So, a little couple of notes to add. Noun before adjective. And what I like to call the discount double check. There's an old insurance commercial that they always say the discount double check. And the reason I say that, because always check the adjective with the gender and the number. So check gender and number for your discount double check. And that is how we use our nouns with our adjectives in sentences. Now, this is just using definite articles. I'm gonna erase my board, and I'm gonna show you that we can do the exact same thing with indefinite articles. So a few moments ago, we had it say the tall boy, the tall boys. Well, just take out the word the, and it still works. If I want it to go a tall boy is un chico alto, or unos chicos altos. If I want to be a tall girl, una chica alta, or some tall girls, unas chicas altas. Now again though, we talked about whenever we use noun adjective agreement, we have to discount double check. We have to check the gender and the number at all times, gender and number. So here, if we go back up, just to make sure, masculine singular, masculine singular, masculine singular, masculine plural, masculine plural, and masculine plural. And then for feminine, singular feminine, singular, and singular feminine. And then again, plural feminine, and plural feminine. It's all put together like a well-developed outfit. It all has to match. Now, not every adjective ends in the letter O. On your vocab list, you're gonna see some other adjectives, such as the adjective for, we'll say, inteligente, intelligent. Inteligente does not end in the letter O. It ends in the letter E. I say if the adjective ends in an O, it opens itself up for change. If it ends in an E, you let it be. What do I mean by that? Is if it ends in an E, I can't change the masculine versus feminine, but I can change it to singular versus plural. I can add an S to make it inteligentes. So, watch this. So what I've just done is taken the adjective inteligente. Remember, if the adjective ends in an O, it opens itself up for change. But if it ends in an E, you let it be. Therefore, I took intelligente. I can say the intelligent boy or an intelligent boy and make it un chico inteligente, leaving it in the original form. Una chica inteligente. All this side is singular. I can't change the gender. Ends in E, you let it be. But I can make a plural, inteligentes, by adding an S. So unos chicos inteligentes and unas chicas inteligentes. So again, I'm still doing the discount double check. I'm checking, can I match the number and gender? Sometimes that ability is taken away from us if the word ends in an E. But you can always double check for number. And that's it. That's noun adjective agreement. So before we finish, make sure you write down a minimum of 2 questions for me to ask later on in class to discuss. And we're going to keep working on this as progress into the sentences. Hasta mañana.